Welcome to BloombergQuint, and we are joined by V. Srinivasan, CFO at Godrej Consumer. Apt time to get him, simply to do with the fact that a lot of changes and transition happening in the FMCG space, and you know, he's probably the one to get all the answers you know, for our viewer queries. And you know, sir, starting with the expansion plans, you know, first quarter was slightly slower for most of these domestic you know, FMCG companies. So in terms of capex moving forward, have you rolled down or on capex, or probably it continues the way it was planned you know, earlier for most of the companies?
Thank you, Yatin, for the kind words.
Yeah.
See, FMCG as a sector doesn't have too much of capex.
Right.
Our capex typically is about 2 to 3% of turnover.
Mm.
Recently, we went on stream with our plant in Jammu,
mm.
in Kathua region.
Mm.
It's the first phase. We have one more plant going on. So, essentially, the capex is not really a bottleneck in this industry. Largely, you know, the investment is behind brands. So overall, I think we have enough cash flows, and the capacity also is quite comfortable.
Mm.
We are utilizing about 60-70% of our capacity.
Right.
Also, we continuously debottleneck
mm.
our capacities in our cost efficiency improvement programs, etc.
Mm. Mm.
And overall, we have sufficient cash flows for managing the routine capex that we need.
Okay, so that was for domestic. You have a very large global presence as well. So on that front also, you have good investment plans, if you could
elaborate.
So
basically, the industry is the same. We are in the fast-moving consumer goods industry.
Right.
So essentially, the capex is quite quite small,
okay.
relative to the brand investments.
Mm-hmm.
So the same logic applies in the international market as well.
Okay. You know, we spoke to a lot of FMCG companies in the first quarter post the earnings, and most of them said that probably second quarter onwards we'll have demand coming back. Probably in India we'll have the festive season as well, which will be a fillip to the demand. So in terms of capacity utilization, in terms of demand coming back, how do you see the trend moving forward?
See, basically the government has now come up with this GST, and there was a little bit of destocking in the trade that happened
right.
in the first quarter, and therefore
right.
many companies reported lower than usual growth in sales.
Okay.
But the secondary sales for us has been quite good,
mm.
and we expect that would actually feed into the primary demand as well. And we are seeing good traction in terms of the offtakes from our distributors,
mm.
and we expect the demand to pick up, particularly as you rightly said, because of the festive season ahead.
Okay.
And generally, the with GST, people are also expecting
mm.
that the GDP will grow by 1 to 2 percentage point over
okay.
time. And
okay.
that augurs well for the FMCG, which is typically 1.6, 1.7x
mm.
The GDP. That's the kind of growth FMCG sector has been having empirically.
Okay. And sir, talking about the input cost, you know, most of the companies are facing tailwinds, many of them have headwinds. So when it comes to your company, Godrej Consumer, how is the cost structure really put up right now? Do you think input costs are slightly on the higher side and could put some pressure on margins moving forward?
Input costs have been moving up over the last few quarters.
Okay.
So there are two parts to our raw material, you know, basket. One is the vegetable oil based raw material,
mm,
so which
mm.
goes into soaps and categories.
Yeah.
There actually over the last 1 year, the input cost has gone up by about 10 to 15%.
Okay.
And this typically gets passed on to the consumers over a period of time. And that has got passed on in the form of reduced offers, etc., and some price
okay.
hikes. So you see the price led growth in soaps in the first quarter, you would have seen in our results. As far as the crude oil goes, it has been generally flat. There was an expectation it will go up, but right now the sense is that it will remain stable around the same level. And also the lag effect, because it's a very indirect raw material which impacts your packing material, your solvents and things like that, it will take some time to catch up. So we don't expect much change in the input costs on that front.
Okay. In terms of the overall you know, industry structure, if you could give us your thoughts on how GST has probably been as a transition for you, because you know, there were various issues that the distributors were facing, retailers were facing. Of course, the company level IT infrastructure would be much stronger to handle the situation.
Yes.
But when you go to the ground, you know, what is the kind of feedback that you are getting for the industry? And, you know, is the adjustment moving well so that we can have a strong second, third quarter of growth?
See, GST is a game-changing tax reform. So obviously, everyone was expecting a bit of disruption, at
okay.
least for the first two quarters.
Mm-hmm.
We have prepared quite well. I mean, we have been preparing quite well for
mm.
the last 1 year or so in
okay.
preparation for that.
Okay.
We have done web-based training for our distributors, our channel partners, etc. So their readiness was not an issue for us. Our first invoice rolled out, I think, on 2nd of July.
Okay.
And therefore, in terms of transition, we didn't find much issue. The moot point is how the GST network scales up to the return filing and matching of invoices and things like that. That would happen in due course. As far as the ground level goes, I think in terms of channel, our first level channel partners, distributors, modern trade, etc., they are all very well prepared.
Okay.
I think a little bit of issues are there at the wholesale level. I think they will also, we are providing the support required in terms of their getting ready onto the system. And I think over a period of time, maybe in this quarter, things should come back to normalcy.
Okay.
That's the expectation.
Okay. So that was Mr. Srinivasan, CFO at Godrej Consumer, sharing his thoughts on the FMCG sector and how input costs are moving up. Probably most of it is passed on to consumers, and also he spoke about as to how GST transition is moving in a smooth manner, and probably in the second quarter we should see some green shoots with the festive season going on for the FMCG sector.